Welcome to video 4 for this unit on rigid transformations and congruence. In this video, we're going to focus on angles in a triangle. When two lines intersect, vertical angles are equal and adjacent angles are supplementary. That is, their measures sum to 180. For example, in this figure, angles 1 and 3 are equal. And angles 2 and 4 are equal. It is also true that angles 1 and 4 are supplementary, that is, their sum is 180 degrees, and angles 2 and 3 are also supplementary. When two parallel lines are cut by another line, we call the third line a transversal. A transversal for a pair of parallel lines is a line that meets each of the parallel lines in exactly one point. Alternate interior angles are created when two parallel lines are crossed by a transversal. Alternate interior angles are inside the parallel lines and on the opposite sides of the transversal. For example, in this figure, angles 3 and 5 are alternate interior angles, and angles 4 and 6 are also alternate interior angles. Alternate interior angles are equal because a 180-degree rotation around the midpoint of the segment that joins their vertices takes each angle to the other. If we label that point M, and then rotate the three lines 180 degrees about M, we see the rotation takes angle 3 to angle 5 and angle 4 to angle 6. Using what we know about vertical angles, adjacent angles, and alternate interior angles, we can find the measures of any of the 8 angles created by a transversal if we know just one of them. For example, starting with the fact that angle 1 is 70 degrees, we use vertical angles to see that angle 3 is 70 degrees. Then we use alternate interior angles to see that angle 5 is 70 degrees. Then we use the fact that angle 5 is supplementary to angle 8. To see that angle 8 is 110 degrees, since 180 minus 70 equals 110. It turns out that there are only two different measures. In this example, angles 1, 3, 5, and 7 measure 70 degrees, and angles 2, 4, 6, and 8 measure 110 degrees. A 180 degree angle is called a straight angle because when it's made with two rays, they point in opposite directions and form a straight line. If we experiment with angles in a triangle, we find that the sum of the measures of the three angles in each triangle is 180 degrees. This is the same as a straight angle. For any triangle, if we add the three angles of the triangle physically by cutting them off and lining up the vertices and sides, then the three angles form a straight angle. Using parallel lines and rotations, we can understand why the angles in a triangle always add up to 180 degrees. Here is triangle ABC. Line DE is parallel to AC and contains point B. A 180 degree rotation of angle ABC around the midpoint of AB interchanges angles A and DBA, so they have the same measure. In the picture, these angles are marked as X degrees. 180-degree rotation of triangle ABC around the midpoint of BC interchanges angles C and CBE, so they have the same measure. In the picture, these angles are marked as Z degrees. Lastly, we know that DBE is a straight line because 180-degree rotations take lines to parallel lines, as seen by the rotations of triangle ABC around the midpoint of AB and the midpoint of BC. So the three angles with vertex B make a line, and they add up to 180 degrees. X plus Y plus C is equal to 180. But X, Y, and Z are the measures of three angles in the triangle ABC. So the sum of the angles in the triangle is always 180 degrees. Thank you for watching video 4 of 4 for this unit on rigid transformations and congruence.